Standing Simmer here today, and welcome back to the channel for another apartment renovation in The Sims 4. So guys, this was kind of like a random type video. I didn't actually intend to share this specific video with you guys today. So my Tuesday schedule that here recently has been kind of weird. So just hear me out for a second and we'll get to the build here in just a minute. But Tuesdays have been kind of weird because up until like a week or two ago, I've been posting specifically building up Windenburg builds on the channel, specifically on Tuesdays. I already said the word specifically like 150 times, but more on Tuesdays than anything. And then Thursdays also occasionally tend to be a build day for me as well. But here recently, just with like the onset of some news for The Sims 4 and my lack of free time and the introduction of some new opportunities like collabs and things like that, my Tuesday schedule has been kind of weird, as and the rest of the schedule has kind of followed suit. Oh my gosh, man, guys, it is a Monday when I'm recording this right now. I just got home from a really long shift at work and my brain feels like eggs right now. That's kind of what it feels like. But guys, I just wanted to give you an update and to say that, especially in lieu of the recent news of the introduction of terrain tools in The Sims 4, I don't feel like I need to tell many of you that. I imagine a lot of you know that that's actually a thing by now. But in case you don't know, with the introduction of terrain tools, as stated in last week's live stream by The Sims, I'm kind of thinking about holding off my Building Up Windenburg series indefinitely, more until after that patch comes out. And when we get terrain tools, I feel like I would really hate to not be able to use that, especially in a world like Windenburg. If I was doing something like, I don't even know, I'm sure Oasis Springs you could do like sand dunes and things like that and it would look really cool. But specifically Windenburg, guys, I mean, Windenburg kind of needs some hills. In fact, I kind of hate that I've gotten as far through Windenburg as I already have, because I feel like terrain and Windenburg go hand in hand. So long story short, every build, reno, anything like that is likely going to be non-Windenburg related from here on out until after that patch comes out. And until after I figure out how terrain tools actually work, because I know that none of us exactly right now know how they're supposed to work, because all we've had is a live stream and that little itty bitty like video clip of content and that's it. But guys, okay, confession time. I have never used terrain tools in The Sims, like not in any Sims game. I know that, I don't know, do they have them in Sims 2? I honestly don't know. But I do know that Sims 3 terrain tools, obviously such a big part of building. However, I hardly ever did any building whatsoever in The Sims 3. I've talked about this before, I played a lot of Sims 3, still do on occasion. However, don't do a lot of building in Sims 3 and have never ever attempted terrain tools in The Sims 3. And I'm kind of nervous as a result of that as to how my usage of terrain tools is going to look. I'm excited but nervous at the same time, so it's gonna take me a little while to figure it out. I already have some things in mind that I know I want to do, but guys, that's a very long way to say, that's a very long introduction into the video to say that building up Windenburg temporarily on hold until after I figure out terrain tools after they come out, because I'm really excited to implement that into what I see Windenburg being. So guys, like I said, long introduction to say that my Tuesday videos are kind of random right now. Last week I also shared an apartment renovation, and that is again what we were doing this week. And both apartment renovations I've shared in two consecutive weeks have been for my not-so-berry family. Guys, I don't exactly know what I'm gonna call this video just yet. It's essentially what this apartment ends up being is like this big luxury family apartment. So there's a lot of space. It's in one of the Uptown apartments. This is actually 1020, I believe. So 1020 Alto apartments. It's in Uptown. It is this beautiful, large, sprawling apartment, single level, has amazing big glass windows that kind of border the side of the building that looks out into the world. And it's just one of my favorite apartments to plan. Again, because it is single level, but it is so big and it has such amazing views. So I really wanted my not-so-berry family to live here, specifically the family dynamic that I am creating this for not-so-berry-wise, just in case you're not keeping up with my current household. Actually, even if you are keeping up with my current household, you're still kind of like, this is like a sneak peek a little bit. I'm a little ahead current household-wise, like in my gameplay compared to what I am video-wise on my channel. So just keep that in mind. I think what just happened on my channel is that I introduced you to my gray generation sim, but I'm actually building this for a plum generation sim and her parents and her children. So this is like, it's a multi-generational apartment. You have lots of colors going on here. Gray for the gray generation, plum or purple for the purple generation, and orange for the orange generation. So three consecutive generations of not-so-berry was who I intended to live in this apartment. And The really cool thing is that even if you guys aren't playing Not So Berry, even if you guys don't exactly think that those colors are some that would appeal to you, you can definitely still play in this apartment because, you know, obviously changing color swatches is a thing, and you know, you don't have to be playing Not So Berry to have Sims that like those kind of colors. So long story short, like I said, that's kind of what we're doing today. That's like the general overview. Kind of a, like a sprawling large family apartment that was built with a pretty reasonable budget in mind. I actually don't even know exactly what this apartment ends up coming to as far as price goes. I really don't know what the budget was. I wasn't working from one in my mind because dadgum, this family already has so much money. Guys, have you ever played a legacy family for a while and all of a sudden you just find that you have loads of money? Like you never have to worry about money again in your Sims lifetimes because they have so much money. I usually get to the point in legacies that I start to cheat down my Sims money because they end up with so much of it that I don't even really feel like it's fun to play the game financially anymore, because I actually do enjoy like the struggling aspect of the Sims. Rarely when I create a current household do I like give them a crap ton of money, you know, like set them up in a mansion, make sure that they're living high in life. I mean, rarely do I set up my current households that way. Usually I prefer to start from the bottom. Like, so we're talking rags to riches style, we're talking like legacy challenge style, we're talking starter home budget style. You know, very rarely do I tend to start my Sims off in the lap of luxury. I like them to work up to that point instead. So when I get to this point in a legacy and my families have kind of molded one into another, and that money just keeps rolling over from generation to generation, I end up with a lot of it. And so typically what I end up doing, you guys have to let me know how you handle that situation, even if you think that that's, you might not even think that's a problem. Like you guys might like to retain that amount and like see how much you've earned even with expenses by the time you reach the end of a 10 generation legacy. You guys have to let me know what you do with that, like in that regard. But I typically cheat down the money when you get to a certain point. So like when they have so much money, it's like stupid how much money they have. I typically start to cheat it down, and usually I'll cheat them down so that like realistically they could afford like one or two bill cycles if they're living in an apartment, for example, and then just kind of like let them start building it back up again. I just think that that's a fun way to play. So yeah, with all that being said, I did not pay attention to budget in this apartment. However, I have no idea how much it costs. I really, really don't know. But guys, as far as the other specs of the build go, we ended up with four bathrooms and three bedrooms. And I thought that that was halfway decent because the original apartment that was placed here is where Diego Lobo lives. I don't know if you guys know where that location is in Uptown in San Myshuno. However, Diego Lobo lives here and he has a one bedroom apartment. Like this, picture this whole apartment, as large as it is, as massive and sprawling as it is, one bedroom. Like that's it. I mean, he is like an arts critic or something like that, and he's single and he's like living in the city. He's got a really cool fashion, really cool style, but this is all the space he has to just one person. So I was kind of enjoying the challenge of turning it into a bit of a larger apartment as far as how many rooms I could fit in it and thereby how many Sims I could fit in this build. So all in all, it ends up being that at the present moment where it stands, if you download it right now, you could fit up to 5 Sims in this apartment. Now, the kids bedroom that we've been working on here for a little while, which obviously, like I said, is very orange themed. You see a ton of those colors. Like, I won't even say that like that's an influencing color. That's like a dominant color in this room here. I've really been enjoying this whole like separating off a playroom to the kids room. And that way they have like their sleeping quarters and their, I don't even know, like some playing quarters, but mainly not, more just like sleeping, dressing, some other cool little skill building stuff, but mainly just that. And then in the other side of that kids room, there being like actual toys, and he has like a hamster in there and all that kind of stuff. So I've really been enjoying separating off kids rooms that way. I feel like I had a thought a moment ago. Yes, I was talking about how many kids and how many people in general you could fit into this apartment. The kids room is so big that you could very, very easily stick another single size bed in there and fit more than one child. Because to be honest with you, if I had that bedroom growing up, I would just be, I wouldn't even know what to do with myself, guys. Like, I don't know what your living situation was when you were growing up. I've never had a bedroom to myself, like not my entire life. I'm the oldest of 5 kids, which means that I was almost always sharing a bedroom with at least one of my sisters, if not multiple sisters. And Then at the same time that I was moving out of my parents' house, I was getting married. So like I've never had a bedroom all to myself. So I could not even imagine what it would be like to live in an apartment like this and to be that kid who has not one room, but two plus a bathroom to himself. Like this kid has an ensuite. It's ridiculous. But guys, you'll have to let me know if like what, have you ever had your own bedroom or have you always had to share? Has it been a mixture throughout your life? Like perhaps if you're a younger sibling, I could totally picture you like having to share a room with an older sibling until that older sibling moves out, for example, and then you get your own bedroom. But I don't know anyone that's happened to be honest with you. So you guys have to let me know like what your living situation was. Or perhaps if you are an only child and then of course like always by default you get your own bedroom. So and that'd be pretty cool. I think that'd be pretty nice. So by now guys, we've already kind of like moved through, of course, furnishing off the kids' bedroom that I was telling you about, the very orange-themed bedroom. And then we moved into furnishing what I more pictured to be the bedroom for my gray generation Sims. Especially in a legacy like this, I've kind of been wanting to keep all the family together so that when those Sims die, I can capture their gravestones and they don't just kind of get lost. I've been pretty good about that so far. I actually have managed to maintain all of the gravestones of like my previous, well, specifically my founder and then every heir up until where I am now in the gameplay, and I'm really hoping to be able to continue that. I also really like playing with grandparents in the same family as, you know, their kids and their kids' kids. I think that that dynamic is really very cool, and I know that it's not everybody's playing style, but as a very family-oriented gameplay person myself, I really like playing with elders in a household. Now, I know this is something that's kind of been talked about a lot in the simming community, and I am definitely like in a full support of this idea, but I know a lot of people have been talking about wanting to make that elder life stage a little bit more valuable in that like there are more elder-specific activities, perhaps even like, I don't even know, like maybe even skill building items that are like just specifically for elders. I would name things like knitting, but like I knit and I'm 23, so I like that's not exactly, that doesn't really make sense if I hold for knitting to be like an elder only type skill. But just things like that, or like I said, like shuffleboard, or things that are kind of like just like stereotypically elder life stage. And I really would just oh so love to see more creative options for elders. I always feel kind of lost when it comes to like making my Sims look good as elders when they transition into that life stage, because there are so few good clothing items that I feel like work. So like if my Sim always has like this really casual, comfy, that was my ankle popping just then, by the way, I don't know if you heard that, but they always have like this, like say if my Sim has a casual, comfy, hippie, boho, whatever, like just throw like a more casual style in there and then they become an elder. Like just about the only clothing items that look appropriate on elders are like the suits and like the nicer type clothing that I rarely even give my regular young adult and adult Sims. So it's like they go from being these like boho people and loving the simpler things in life to like dressing really fancy and snazzy looking when they're older. And that might happen to some people, but in reality, I don't feel like that's actually a thing, so I could be wrong there, but I really don't think that that's a thing. So I would love to see more expansion of the elder life stage. I think that that would be absolutely fantastic. And then guys, I was kind of trying to describe some of the rooms that we were moving through just a little while ago, but there's this big casual kind of skill building, hanging out, like family style room with like a TV and a gaming console and a radio and an office area, and it leads into the bathroom that's like the main, I would say like more the main guest bathroom. Like every other bathroom in the house is an ensuite. This is the main one, only it does have like the washer and dryer and stuff in there too. So it's a pretty big bathroom, but I think it serves the purpose pretty well. And then at the very, very far end of the apartment, you have the purple generation room, or the plum room, whatever you want to call it. Very purple themed. I also threw some teal in there because I think those two colors look really well together. I know absolutely nothing about interior design, but I feel like that, again, those two colors look good together. At least they did when I was decorating this apartment. And then of course, that bedroom as well has an ensuite too. So your Sims, as many as you choose to fit in this apartment, should have no shortage of bathrooms whatsoever, because they are well populated in here, guys. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and mention that this build is available on the gallery. You can find it there if you search for my user, which is standingsimmer. And I also put it under the hashtag standingsimmer. It is player tested. I forget to mention that sometimes, but I almost always player test my stuff, especially if things look a little iffy, if something's a little too tight or I'm kind of not really sure about it when it comes to actually putting it together. I do player test my builds, unless I'm just in such a rush I can't bother, which is very rarely. So guys, it is up on the gallery. Down the link will be in the description as long as the gallery is cooperating. And a fun little fact, I actually took the screenshots at night because I thought that these stars looking through the windows just looked absolutely gorgeous. So guys, I am gonna go ahead and leave you off right there, but thank you so much for watching. I really, really appreciate it. I hope you're having the best of days and I will see you very soon. Bye.
I'm so happy, I can't lie, I'm so happy, I can't lie, I'm so happy.